Today, we're going to talk about DNA versus RNA. So you might remember that DNA and RNA are nucleic acids. These are a kind of biomolecule we talked about early in class. Now these biomolecules, DNA and RNA, they're polymers. They're long stretches of repeated nucleotides. The top picture here in black is a very simplified diagram of a polymer of DNA. Whereas on the bottom of the screen, that's a very simplified version of a polymer of RNA. So as we talk about these, it's important to remember that all life uses nucleic acids. We all have the same code. So here in the bottom you see a bacterial cell, even viruses use DNA and RNA. And then if we have big multicellular life, like crabs and elephants, the cells inside these kind of life forms also have DNA and RNA. So DNA and RNA are used by all life. To help us understand the major differences between DNA and RNA, let's start with this quick video.
So now let's talk about the structure of DNA and the structure of RNA. This would be RNA on one side, and this would be DNA on the other. The one thing that jumps out is that RNA is a single helix, and DNA is a double helix. But if we look at the structure of both of these, which are called nucleic acids, they're mostly made up of just three parts. Both of them have a sugar. In RNA, that sugar is going to be ribose sugar. In DNA, it's going to be deoxyribose sugar. They then have a phosphate group. And then they have bases on the inside. And so if we look at, this would be RNA right here. On RNA, you have a phosphate attached to a ribose sugar, attached to a phosphate, attached to a ribose sugar, attached to a phosphate, ribose sugar, phosphate, ribose sugar. And so the backbone, which on here would be this kind of greenish part that goes down here, is simply a phosphate attached to a sugar, attached to a phosphate, attached to a sugar. That's relatively boring. It's the same all the way down. Now, if it's DNA, it's going to have a deoxyribose attached to a phosphate, deoxyribose, and it's going to be the same side on both sides of that backbone. What goes off the inside attached to the sugar is going to be the base or the nitrogenous base. And so in RNA, it's adenine, guanine, uracil, and cytosine. So we've got cytosine, guanine, adenine, and uracil. If you look at DNA, the bases that we have are cytosine, guanine, adenine, and thymine. And so this is another difference between the two. In RNA, it's going to be a uracil. In DNA, it's going to be thymine. But if you look at the structure of those two chemicals, it's almost identical. And so they serve the same purpose. DNA is simply a double helix. So it's going to have bases on either side. And so if we have an A on this side, then we'll have a T on the other side.
As mentioned in the video, DNA and RNA have some major differences. First, they have a difference in their sugars. DNA uses deoxyribose and RNA uses ribose. So you can see those over here to the right. Ribose is here on the top and deoxyribose is here on the bottom. You'll notice that down here there's no oxygen in deoxyribose, but in ribose there is an oxygen. The other difference is with the nucleotides. DNA uses A, T, G, and C, whereas RNA uses A, U, G, and C. This is one way we can tell these two biomolecules apart. DNA, as he mentioned, is double-stranded, whereas RNA is single-stranded. The location is also different. DNA is located in the nucleus in eukaryotes, and it always stays there. It never, ever leaves the nucleus. Whereas RNA might be generated in the nucleus, but then it can leave and go into the cytoplasm. RNA is also relatively transient. It's not a permanent structure. It gets degraded after we use it, whereas the DNA is often permanent. And then finally, when we come down here to this last row, function is different. The DNA is information. It's our permanent source of information, whereas RNA is really just a copied piece of information, a message that we're going to use further for translation. So that brings us to a reminder about the central dogma. We start with double-stranded DNA, and then we make a copy of that in RNA. That's a single-stranded form of the message. And then outside of the nucleus, we translate that into protein, that three-dimensional structure. So the way we've taught this to you in the past is that DNA is kind of like a big book of instructions, but it's instructions for everything you could possibly need to be made in the whole cell. And RNA really is a one-page copy of a piece of information or a piece of those instructions that you're going to need right now. It's not a copy of the whole book, it's just a copy of what you need right now. And then with that RNA, we're actually able to build something that our cell needs right now. Okay, that's all we have for you today. See you in class.